providing high-quality craftsmanship and auto body repairs for over 38 years. Saugus Autocraft is the only choice on the North Shore. If you've been in an accident, minor or major, drop it off with a dented bumper or a smashed-in door, and when you pick it up, it will look like it came off the showroom floor. Mention this ad and get $25 off for work over $250 with 100% guarantee and repairs. Time to make the easy choice. Call Saugus Autocraft today at 781-586-8781.
Than you are on the outside.
I hope that you think so.
I don't know, but that's what I'm hearing. That's what I hear. Your eyes might be bluer than mine.
You do have very blue eyes.
So I'm Mr. Monday. I'm Carlo. Give me knuckles.
Very nice to meet you.
I want to know if you love Mondays.
You want to know what I do? For my job, it's always something different every day. My Mondays aren't always the same. I feel very fortunate to have to go to a 9-to-5 and really get to do what I love, which is traveling and meeting new people and spreading my message around the world. So honestly, sometimes I don't even know what day of the week is, so I do love a Monday.
Now let me ask you a question. Are you on the cover of Sports Illustrated?
I am one of the covers of Sports Illustrated swimsuit, yes.
I mean, that's like exclusive. How did that whole process happen?
You know, it's a long, long story. It's 12 years of hard work and passion and chasing something that meant so much more than just a photo and a cover to me. This is a place that I knew that I could take a platform and really capitalize on it and do for others as a lot of those cover models have done for me, which is to remind me to accept all that I am and the skin that I'm in, enjoy the journey, and don't conform to any standards. As soon as you own who you are, some of the best things and freeing things in life come, and that's exactly when that cover came about for me at that point in my life.
Now, I get sick of people making such a big deal about me because I'm cute. Now, what about you? Do you get sick of people making a big deal about you? About your beauty?
I mean, I think it's very, very flattering. I love...
Just some days you just want to stay home, like, leave me alone.
I definitely need one day a week where I can just chill and hang out and unwind and reflect. But wouldn't you so much rather be loved than hated? So
of course.
Your biggest problem is that people think you're too cute all the time, I think you're doing good.
I'm a Leo. I want to be loved all the time. You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
So, now, what about Gronk? Now, there's a million girls in the world who love that guy.
Yes.
And he's yours. Like, I mean, that's unbelievable.
I feel very lucky. He's a great guy. We have so much fun together.
Awesome.
He is one of my best friends.
Awesome.
Each year just keeps getting better and better.
He seems like a great guy. I think you guys are more of a power couple than Tom and Giselle, by the way. I think you blow them away, actually.
We get compared a lot to them, but whenever we all hang out, the four of us just love kicking in, hanging out together. No comparison there. Tom and Giselle are the power couple. So, you know, Rob and I definitely have our own careers and we love working together, supporting each other. So if that's the definition of a power couple, I definitely think that we're doing a good job.
Well, listen, God bless you. I'm honored to meet you. You're a very nice person. Listen, your beauty outside doesn't matter to me. You're beautiful inside. That's all I care about.
That's all that matters.
So check us out. I have a t-shirt for you I'm going to give to you tonight, too.
Amazing.
I got it right here. We want you to put it on whenever you can.
Okay.
And wear it for the brand. It'll help us out so much.
It's a woman's size, too.
Oh, yeah, of course.
I love Mondays.
Isn't that the best? Whenever you can wear that sometime, post it for us. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Thank you.
Great job. I'll leave you alone. You got everyone hounding you. Monday! Welcome to the I Love Monday Show. I'm your host, Mr. Monday. Tonight, I got Donnie Z here right next to me.
Boom!
Because, you know, Kat's not here tonight because she's dog-sitting.
Yeah, fuck her.
I mean, oh, Jesus. I mean, honestly, Kat, what are you dog-sitting?
You can't put the dog, like...
You can't bring a dog to the show?
Yeah.
You know?
Hey, or leave the dog in a responsible, safe place. It's not even, it's an Audi, it's below 80. It's safe to put
it's
the dog
Serpinade,
in the car.
It's a Serpinade, is that true, Klusky?
I don't know, but chaining it to a train sounds like a perfectly fine thing to do,
right? Now, McCluskey.
Oh, and the Be A Man guys had a huge birthday party at this guy Duncan's house. We got to say happy birthday to Duncan. All right.
Happy birthday, Duncan.
It's a tree. He has like a tree house. It's a house made out of trees. It's like one of those.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks for explaining that.
And he has hanging. Listen, he has hanging like coyotes in the house and everything.
He has hanging coyotes?
Yeah, dead stuff. Got him stuffed and stuff. And
Jesus Christ.
Deer and everything, that guy.
Like
he has a lion
they
in there.
The animals? Or?
He has a lion. Like he's one of those guys who's got things
like
on the wall.
Like the mounted?
Yeah, you know those things? I don't know what you call them, but taxidermy?
Big game hunter.
So you just watched that video of Gronk's girl, Camille. We interviewed her. We had this great event the other night. Where were you?
I had a show.
You had a show on a Tuesday night?
Yeah, I'm kind of a big deal.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't think Tuesday night was a big deal.
Well, there is Italian-American clubs all over the state that need to be entertained. So.
But all the stars were out that night, and all the wannabe stars were out that night, and we had a great time. Maddie Magazine does a great job. Wasn't he great?
That was a great night. I'm telling you, man, I drank a lot of Whiskey Cokes.
How many?
Half as many as post patterns that I caught from a legendary Sopranos actor.
Yeah, we're throwing the football around out there.
Yeah, we were just basically harassing anybody with a golf club.
So tell me about your show. You had a show this weekend.
Oh, it was wonderful. Don was there. Dave Russo was there. Chris Justice was there. I wasn't there.
You said it was wonderful, like it wasn't that great.
Well, that's why
it went great, but I got food poisoned and spent the entire show throwing up in an Uber ride to my house.
You think like another comedian poisoned you so you wouldn't show up?
I don't think anybody would bother with me.
And guess who took those 4 minutes?
Was it you? Stole his time? So it was a great show?
It was a great time.
American Legion?
Yeah.
Heard it was all smoky.
It's one of the finest American Legions on the entire North Shore.
Where is it?
It's in Medford, off of Winthrop Street.
Sure, I was at a funeral there.
Good vibe.
Yeah, but I heard it was all smoke. They still smoke in there?
Yeah, they can smoke inside. It blew my mind.
How'd you like it?
I felt like it was 1985. It was home.
Great. Who's I'm becoming a member.
Who's Miss Monday this week?
Miss Monday this week is Melissa from Texas. She's a gym owner and has been a personal trainer who's been inspiring people for the past 21 years.
She's inspiring the shit out of me right
Melissa's
now.
Melissa's motto is never miss a Monday. Miss Monday this week is brought to you by John's Roast Beef at 111 Western Avenue in Lynn. For the best roast beef, salads, and seafood, call 781-595-6105 today.
Where is she? Oh, Melissa, Texas?
She's in Texas.
She's in Texas, and she's a gym owner. She owns a gym.
Please explain to the people at home what a gym owner is, because I didn't know.
It's a gym owner down south.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Gym owner.
A gym owner witness.
Yeah. We're trying to be sensitive to the other viewers across the country. We're not just the North Shore.
She actually had the best attitude out of all the Miss Monday so far.
What does that mean?
She had a great attitude. You know, they all have good attitudes, but she's like has the greatest attitude.
About a Monday and about being positive
she's
and
positive.
About making that
she lives on Mondays. She's all fired up about them. Selling shirts for us and everything.
That's pretty cool.
She's doing pretty good. All right, let's shoot the shit. Man impaled on a stump and left stranded for 14 hours after falling out of a tree.
This unnamed man, who was 37 years old, fell from a tree near a wooded area of the college campus at Michigan State University. He laid there for 14 hours impaled on a large tree stump. People finally found him, and a runner asked, "Why were you up in the tree?" And he said, "I really enjoy nature." Nobody knows why he was up there. They're not releasing the guy's name. What is this 37-year-old doing in the top of a tree?
I think he was like John Belushi in Animal House, like up on the ladder. Looking into a...
Peeping on what, a couple of squirrels?
Yeah. He was a sorority, for God's sakes.
He's in the forest.
Is that what you call a vagina or a squirrel?
Well, what is he going to be peeping on if he's in the forest? That's my point. I think
a wooded area of the college campus. It is a wooded area of the college campus, so that Bluto theory is not uncommon.
Well, then I take it back.
Yes.
He's 37, but we don't know his name, but we know his age.
No, but I bet he owns a telescope in Lubriderm.
What kind of tree was it, Don?
It looks like one made out of wood.
What country? It's Michigan State University. This is local. This is a guy who was
Michigan
clearly...
Michigan State, that's local?
He said, what country?
East Lansing, Michigan. Yeah, it's East Lansing, right?
Yeah, it is.
Welcome back to the show, everybody. There's a man jerking off the top of a tree looking at a college university. We're going to beat around the bush, but this guy prefers the bush, and that's what he's jerking off to here.
So he was 14 hours impaled in this thing. How did he not bleed out? That's what I want to know.
I'm more
because all the blood was in his dick.
So he was admiring
if
nature.
If he's right next to the campus, why wasn't he getting cell phone reception?
That's a good question. He probably dropped the cell phone. You got one hand on your, you know, come on.
Imagine going down. And
how
you
do you
know
climb a tree with a...
With a cell phone in your pocket? Jeez, yeah. I don't know. And probably the way you climb a tree normally.
It's not good. This is... But he's clearly hiding something. When the staff comes, if you don't have a legitimate, you just say, "Oh, I'm a bird watcher, and I just had a once in a lifetime find here." Make up something better than. Okay, you were jerking off to the college campus, but you don't tell them that. What do you tell them? You're on the spot,
do
right?
You climb
now.
Trees, Don.
Sir, what happened? What are you
doing? I haven't climbed a tree in months.
Ah, see.
I don't know. It does sound a little shady.
Yeah,
it's a little weird.
It's a leaf joke.
Tree pun.
Okay. Oscar Mayer offers people the chance to spend the night in a 27-foot-long hot dog.
The limited-time Airbnb will open in Chicago for 3 nights only.
Wienermobile.
For 3 nights only?
3 nights only. This is a 3-night-only thing.
And there's only one Wienermobile, right?
There's only one Wienermobile, and only 2 guests at a time can stay in the Wienermobile, and they only have to pay $136 a night.
Two guests at a time?
Weird. Yeah, so it's a romantic evening with your wife. Guests will also get a custom Wienermobile art piece and a welcome package with dog and hot dog inspired clothing. You guys want to stay a night in this hot dog?
For $136, yes.
Yeah,
count me in.
Absolutely. Jeez,
yeah, you and Joey Chestnut are the only people who want to stay in this thing.
There is a there is a disclaimer. This thing does smell like boiled hot dogs and fucking. So if you want, maybe that's why it's $136.
So does my place, and it's only like $28 a night.
This Wienermobile would be like a hit at like tailgate and parties.
Dude, I think it's they're giving us tremendous value right now. At $136, count me in every fucking day of
two
the week.
Two people? I mean, they're making like $300.
I don't understand why it's
and why
like
it's only for
thing.
Three nights.
It's probably an insurance.
You gotta pay
thing.
For gas?
No, I'm willing to bet it has to stay parked.
Maybe it's electric.
I've never seen an Airbnb that moves.
It's kind of weird. But this would be a hit at like the Indy 500 or campgrounds, you know?
Or general society.
How old is this thing? Well, you're like a hot dog guy, huh?
That looks like a modern one.
Dude, you're telling me you would not stay in that thing? That thing's fucking awesome.
I have no interest to stay in that thing. I want a tricked out bus for like Snoop has, something
can it
like
be
that.
Shaped
I don't want
like
this
a,
thing.
Can it be shaped like a penis, though? Can we shape your bus like a penis?
No, I don't want that. Why would I want a bus shaped like a penis?
Because everybody wants to be on Mr. Monday's hard-on, right?
I don't know. That's not for me. Shambaginis. Brazilian cops shut down factory that produce fake Lamborghinis, Ferraris, and Vespas.
Police discovered factories producing fake luxury sports cars in southern Brazil. Officers say father and son owners took orders for phony cars over social media. Models of these cars sold for up to $60,000, which is only a fraction of the price of the actual sports car. The pair are now facing 3 years in jail on charges of industrial property theft.
Jeez, I wonder how much money they made before they got caught.
More than 60. I mean, 60 grand per car.
Well, how much do you think a car costs to make? Like, I mean, I don't know. You think I got to think that's it still looks like a pretty high-end car. Even if it costs 30 grand, you're still walking with 30 grand.
Yeah, you're doubling your money every car.
Yeah.
And you have a factory. And you're probably not paying that much in southern Brazil. It's all shipping.
I am against it, though, because every person that buys one of these fake Lamborghinis takes away from the power of real Lamborghini owners like myself.
That's true.
So I would not be a party to this.
What color is your Lamborghini?
I have a green one and a red one.
Who rides on the back of your Vespa?
Big fan of Christmas.
Huh?
Tonzo.
All right, let me ask you this question. You get a Vespa. Who's the only male you'd want on the back, and who's the only female you want on the back?
All right, so me and Tom Brady are on our way to the practice facility.
All right.
I'm going to go with Miss Monday for my
this
female.
Week's Miss Monday. Yes. Wow.
She's fucking Jamona.
Yeah.
That's
dedication.
She was pretty legit. Like, I enjoyed that Miss Monday more than I enjoy most of
the really
Miss
cool.
Mondays. And I enjoy Miss Mondays significantly to begin with.
I'm telling you, owning your own business is a big deal. And then, like, being healthy and fit
that's what
is
I was
also
into.
A good deal. So you're looking for a woman who can, like,
goes
run her own
with
life,
loving Mondays.
Stays in shape. What's better than that than, what was I saying? What's it called?
Riding a
Vespa. So these fake Lamborghinis and stuff, I mean, people make fake glasses, golf clubs, watches, that's easy, but I mean, making fake cars, that's like a big deal.
That's smart.
Well, I think it's a real car.
That's
just
big
a
money.
Fake, it's just a fake name.
That's big jail time.
Is it like a Nissan Altima with just a cool shell on it, or is it like a nice, I don't know.
I gotta be honest with you, even if it was, I'd be like, I just park it in front of the house.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like, if anyone gets in, be like, no, I'm responsible.
But if this guy just made 35. Batmobiles instead, he probably would have made the same amount of money and didn't go to jail. Right. That's all I'm saying.
Right. You think he'd get away? Hey, I probably could get away with making.
There's a lot of illegal stuff going on down in Brazil.
I find that hard to believe.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, that's where we're going, right?
We're going there soon.
Cool.
Yep. There's a Miss Monday festival coming up.
Yep. Excuse me, Miss Luenes.
Oh, you speak Spanish? No,
Señorita Luenes.
Conozco español, amigo.
Wow, you speak good.
Well.
Okay, the next one here. West Palm Beach officials are playing annoying children's songs on continuous loop to rid park of homeless people.
Officials in West Palm Beach are playing repetitive children's songs like Baby Shark in a bid to drive the homeless people from the outside Lake Pavilion. The Lake Pavilion is a popular event space that raises over $240,000 in revenue for the city each year. And the city's afraid that the dirty, disgusting homeless people are going to draw away the crowd that comes and spends money there. So with they're playing annoying songs so that the godless, insufferable pieces of scum that are in the streets have nowhere to go.
Wouldn't that drive away the other people, though, as well? I'd be like, if I go listen to this fucking song another time.
Right. I think it's the normal people who are going to get driven away.
Yeah.
Because some of the
They're going to be like, they'll...
It's only at night to keep the vagrants out.
I'm just reading copy here, to be honest.
Well, what do you care if the vagrants stay at night?
Than the moms.
I mean, there is a nightlife for normal people, isn't there? Tonzo? I mean, it's probably a genius move because I hear some of my grandson's songs and music, and I want to run in traffic.
Didn't they do that in World War II and Vietnam and stuff? They would play like scary music to
Apocalypse Now.
Yeah,
yeah, that was a great movie.
Yeah,
what was the one Robin Williams was in?
Apocalypse
Good
Later.
Morning Vietnam.
That was a good one too.
Yeah,
I miss him. Is he a guy's hero because you're comedians? Oh, he's Robin Williams?
Like, not at all. I don't think. I never really digged him.
You never digged Robin Williams?
Not the stand-up. Like, I thought, like, Aladdin was pretty neat, but I mean.
Even his his stand-up, which is probably not even his most impressive thing, is still pretty fucking unbelievable, dude.
I'm just telling you, it didn't hit me the way that.
All right.
Is this an argument? Are you guys having an argument here?
Yeah, we're going to take our pants off later.
Wait, who's your, like, favorite?
My favorite? I like Doug Stanhope's my favorite comedian of all time.
Never heard of him.
My favorite, Eddie Murphy, coming out this week. They just announced he's got a $70 million Netflix stand-up comedy special. I'm pulling for the guy.
$70
million? No, they offered it, right?
He signed it.
He'll get it, actually.
I'm crossing my fingers for him. Because I don't care how good you are, and that guy is, he's ridiculous. Like, it's just so off the charts how good he is. But he's into stand-up in over 30 years. Where do you go to try out material without, like...
He's a natural. Yeah. He's like you. You know?
Are you going to give him that much credit?
No, that's true.
It's even because his brother did it for a while with some success.
Yeah, his brother was good too.
So now I don't know.
Was his brother the barber in Coming to America?
No, his brother's Charlie Murphy.
Wasn't he was all of the people in Coming to America,
yeah.
Wasn't he?
Yeah, right, he was. Okay, here's our last one. First it was Area 51, now it's the Bermuda Triangle.
Facebook user Anthony Dominique Carnaval is planning an event entitled The Storm Bermuda Triangle. It can't swallow us all. 40,000 people have committed to go to this thing. The event is inspired by the recent Facebook storm about Area 51. There are secrets at Area 51. It's obvious the government has them. Whether or not it's aliens or whatever shit, that's different. People want to storm that for answers. People are also doing that with the Bermuda Triangle. My question here is, if you're going there, are you going to prove that it's going to fucking
kill you? You're an idiot if you go there.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense.
You deserve to drown and die if you go there.
You either die or nothing happens, in which case it's the most anticlimactic story that's ever
going to
occur.
Are they going to prove that it's fake, or are they going because they want to find a dragon?
And are they going in a plane, or are they going in a boat? Have they decided yet?
A raft.
A magic fucking carpet for the clientele.
I respect a raft.
We should sell tickets like that fake concert thing that happened. What is that? Can we make money off of this?
Fry.
Let's turn
fire.
This into...
Is it fire?
Fire fest. Oh,
so there's a
Never
guy...
Mind.
There's a guy who started this whole thing, right? I think he's full of crap.
Anthony Dominique Carnaval.
Yeah, he's full of crap,
He's full of crap.
At least, like, Area 51, you can walk there. You know, the sea
is
evil.
It's an actual location. It basically has an address. The Bermuda Triangle, it's kind of a vague thing.
What kind of a statement is...
It's like the Loch Ness Monster.
Swallow us all.
You think it's like the Loch Ness... What do you think?
I mean, yeah, because they're both fucking vague bullshit that no one's ever been able to put their finger on. Yeah.
That's a good question, though, Carlo. Do you think 40,000 Americans could kill the Loch Ness Monster?
If they could find him.
That's the hardest part, but yeah, that's a good point.
But you don't mess with the ocean.
Dude, the ocean is fucked up, man. It really is.
Undefeated.
I gotta start getting the email addresses of all these people that are like, I think the Bermuda Triangle is gonna go there. I want all their email addresses. I feel like I could make money somehow with that. The Hymenex.
I loved your voice as you opposed them.
That's my impression of America.
All right, we're gonna take a quick break. Our newest episode of I'm Offended with Donnie himself, about telemarketers.
Probably gonna be fantastic.
And then we'll be right back with Boston's best, one of Boston's best female comedians, an up-and-comer, Trish Auld.
I'm offended at the resiliency of telemarketers. They're like the Jehovah's Witnesses of cell phones. I'm offended at their ability to persist through a sea of rejection. They're like rogue base runners, just ignoring the third base coach on their way to getting cut down at the plate 99 times out of 100. And for what? So they can sell one extended warranty a day? The average success rate for telemarketers is 1%. Whoever's still buying this crap, for the love of God, just say no. You're keeping this entire industry afloat. If you want to hate 1%ers, hate that 1%. I don't even like talking to people that I like on the phone, never mind a stranger or a robot. I'd rather listen to them drone on endlessly about their fantasy football teams or CrossFit than listen to another goddamn pitch for a 5-day, 4-night getaway to the Dominican Republic! And if you're calling on behalf of a charity, know this much. As soon as I hang up the phone, I'm actively rooting against your charity. So just leave me alone!
We are so lucky to have you back. Did you wash your hands?
I didn't wash my hands. I had to pee real last minute. I did give you a heads up, though. God. You still gave me the high five. Hey, how's my attitude today?
Really good.
Really good? Yeah. As good as Mrs. Monday?
Well, I don't know if it's as good. But,
yeah,
you know.
Okay.
It's always
John,
attitude.
I wasn't asking you.
You have way better earrings than Mrs. Monday.
Thank you. Bubble bar.
Those are really nice. I like those.
Thanks.
No problem. So what's going on? You've been headlining for some, like, the biggest comedians in the country.
It's been awesome. I've been working a lot. Can't complain about that. I'm a working comic, so you probably just don't.
What, do you guys work together, or he just shows up and tries to get a paycheck?
Yeah, no, he tries to do guest spots where I'm performing.
Bullshit.
I heard he tries to get a piece.
Full of shit. I want that stricken from the record.
Don actually has been one of the most supportive comics in Boston comedy for me.
And it doesn't stop her from shitting on me.
Yeah, we tease each other.
Doesn't she loves you, buddy, okay? It's called breaking balls.
Is that what it is, Carlo?
Yeah, I know.
I couldn't piece it together.
Well, yeah. Quit being so feminine.
Yeah, women can break balls, too. I know, Jesus. This is, you know.
No. We're just busting your ovaries.
Yeah, well, they're, you know, dying slowly.
So you're a hit on this new web series, The Real Bachelorette.
Yeah, I like to think that Paige.
Could you tell us
about this? Yeah, Paige and I really have similar personality qualities. I feel like I totally get her energy and her vibe. She's just like, enough with this bullshit facade. Like, let's get some real shit going. Yeah.
Yeah, and the guys that they throw at this girl on that show.
Who are those guys?
They're just pussies.
I mean, honestly, I think they're loosely based on people I've dated. All of them, unfortunately.
Have you dated a lot? How many people have you dated?
I mean, my
parents... 10 or like 100?
Let me be fair, though. I've only introduced my parents to like 3, so...
So, yeah.
At least I'm respectful in that respect.
So 3 good ones.
But yeah, but it's been a revolving door of bullshit.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you punched any guy in the face?
I respect that, though.
No, I have emotionally and with my words punched many men right in the jugular.
I think you look like you're pretty tough. Like, I think you could knock a guy
out. One of my favorite lines, and I want to give this to all the women out there who are around my age dating divorced fathers, because that's all that's out there. One of my best lines, and I use it religiously, when a divorced father fucks me over, I just send a text that says, hey, like, no worries, but I just want you to take some time, reflect, and imagine if someone did this to your daughter. Have a good day. It really fucks them up for a while, I like to think. AKA, they probably go on a date that night and they're like, that girl's crazy. But, yeah.
Klaus, what do we got? Do we want Trish's opinion on something?
All right, let's jump to that. In Florida this week, Jennifer Chapman, another 37-year-old, that's kind of a theme tonight, has been charged with aggravated battery for punching and slashing her boyfriend in the face because he was too tired to have sex. Mm. This seems to be something men often hear from women, but when a man says it, everyone thinks something's wrong with him. Trisha, has a man ever told you he was too tired? And if so, how did you take it?
Yeah.
He doesn't mean emotionally. He means what position. How did you take it?
Comedy by Don Zollo, everyone.
You guys are like brother and sister,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I know. It's unfortunate. We can never have sex. It's too bad. Just two single, lonely people that never fuck.
I'll just have to be part of that exclusive club of seven guys that hasn't had sex with her.
Who would last longer, you or him?
Before Don cried? What are we getting at? Before Don started...
Like, who would cry first?
Well, first of all, Don would be taking it. I would be giving, he would be receiving.
Really? Okay. You got a lump? That's good.
So yes, men have definitely turned me down for sex before, and it was always when they were cheating on me. So thanks, guys. Thanks for the
That's
trauma.
That's a thing? Like, cheating when, like...
John's like, what, they can't fuck a girl and then you also? Yeah.
Well, I got to be honest with you. If you're going out...
There's only so much juice in a person's body.
Oh, you're saying it was a physical thing, not like a... Like, I thought you were saying like a mentally or emotionally.
Don, well, she's going to taste it.
John's old. You're old, so like you get it.
Trish,
like,
do you think Don's a squirter?
I definitely think Don's the type of guy that like... accidentally like went too far one time and like has been apologetic ever since. He's like, I'm so sorry, I didn't realize that I was angled that way and it got on your chin. Like, he's a very thoughtful lover, I'm sure.
Someone's been reading my diary.
As my brother, I know he's a very thoughtful lover.
What do I think about what?
Squirters.
I think that...
No, the right answer, Tim, is I don't think about them.
That's kind of gross.
You know, Super Soakers is kinda, like, pretty good.
Kind of gross. That's leading. You didn't get a... You're planting the seed to give him a direction to go with the answer. You should have just let him...
What are you, a fucking lawyer?
Yeah.
Leading the witness.
Yeah. I was feeling...
I couldn't think of that. That's what I was trying to get out. Yeah.
So you are a squirter, Don.
I have a feeling that girls that squirt are really good at seeming excited at getting a gift.
Yeah.
All right, let's move on.
Yeah, squirting wasn't on the agenda that I received, so I have nothing to add in other than I am one. No, JK, I'm not.
So you get family some, show. You got some huge events coming
huge
up.
Huge events. I'm getting married this week.
What?
Yeah!
Yeah! You're getting married?
Yeah.
Tell us about this.
I'm getting wed, so I decided when I was approached to headline this summer, I decided the best way for me to promote this show was to say that this is my wedding. This is what I've been working towards for the last 6 years while, you know, friends from college got married, divorced, remarried, and now I have a kid. Like, while you were doing all that, I was working towards my comedy dream, and I thought it would be a great way to shame all of my friends into buying tickets, and It worked. Don keeps
making
fun of me.
You sold a ton of
tickets?
Did you hear
about
what
you did? I sold it out over a month early.
Yeah.
So they gave me a second show.
Wow. I love this. She sent out save the dates for her wedding and forgot to include the date.
Yeah, that's no shit. Like, I...
That is off the charts brilliant, beyond compare.
See that? This is my wedding. Nick's Comedy Stop, Boston, Mass, 8 p.m. Everyone's like, Trish... Where's the date? It is kind of great.
You forgot.
Is that who you're marrying on the left?
Date.
I know that.
Is that you when you're younger?
That's, you know, that was pre-trauma, and that's post. That was pre all of my relationships.
Is that confirmation?
Post, yeah, no, first communion.
First communion. Oh, okay.
Confirmation's later in life.
All right.
My hair looked awful that day. I couldn't put it on though.
I think you look kind of cute.
Thanks. Oh, cool. Also, I just want to let the fans know: if I look over 100 pounds, it's about the angle, not me.
Klusk, what else we got on the dish for Trish?
With Trisha Gill.
Oh, God.
Guys.
How long have you been holding that one?
Time out.
I just said it right here.
Little tidbit about that. That was my nickname in high school.
Dish?
The dish. Trish the dish.
I mean, I got lucky.
Wait, it gets better. My ex-boyfriend from high school gave me that nickname. And then I found out years later that it was because of the movie Mallrats, in which the girl called Trish the Dish writes a blog about blowing people.
Yeah, that's...
Oh, thank you.
You left an impression.
How kind.
Eyebrows with laughter.
Hey, you did.
Were there no other Trishes?
You did a good job.
Funny, because it's true.
Well, with Trisha gearing up for the big wedding, we wanted to ask her some wedding-related would-you-rather scenarios to make sure she's ready to make the right decision when she goes into the big day.
Oh, God. Okay, right, I'm ready.
So are we ready?
God.
Trish, would you rather be married to a 10 with a bad personality, or a 6 with an amazing personality?
Well, lately I've been attracting 6s with bad personalities. So anything other than that would be great. I'm definitely, if you see my history, I definitely do not go off looks. Like, some of my sisters have been like, wow, like, you're so open-minded.
I love that there's a sea of dudes watching this right now. Like,
I got a chance.
Like, what, so you've dated some ugly dudes, huh?
Oh yeah, I've had some goddamn monsters.
let's talk about a couple of them.
I don't even trust myself anymore because I'm like, you thought that was the love of your life, you absolutely insane person.
Like guys with acne scars, I mean, what's going on?
There's been some redheads. Yeah,
right there.
There has been.
Redheads can be attractive.
Honestly, there's been more than one redhead. That's how I know my mental illness is showing.
Are they red down below too?
Yeah, actually, it can be consistent at times. I think I've really been very, very open-minded.
Tell us about the most handsome guy you've dated.
I'll tell you about the richest.
Okay. Tell us about him. And why'd you get rid of him?
I didn't get rid of him. He nexted me. He ghosted me.
Come on.
He was one of the dads. He got that text.
You gave me an idea for an app. It would be
so
cool.
He was married, and you were fooling around with him.
No, he was divorced.
He was lying to you.
Yeah, exactly. This is another thing I've learned in dating. If someone says, I'm going through a divorce, that means they're married. They're still married. Hello, da-da.
That is a very good way to say that.
Yeah, thank you, Don. I've thought a lot about it. There's been a lot of them in my life.
Trish, I think I understand where they're leaving from.
Now when guys are like, angry. I'm going through a divorce, I'm like, show me the paperwork, okay?
When's the last time you dated someone?
The last one was the monster. That's why I don't trust myself anymore. That was 2014.
Why do you call him the monster?
I'll show you a picture after this. You'll understand pretty quickly.
Really?
I'm not joking. Like, my sister, I look at my sisters now and I'm like, now I can't trust you bitches because you aren't honest with me.
But why are you dating ugly guys? I mean, you're pretty. I mean, nice.
I just go off personality. If someone can make me laugh, that's like my number one. Like, you could be truly, like, as ugly as Don, and if you can be funny.
I love how that was a double shot, because not only am I not ugly, but I'm not funny. I just want you to know.
Like, if only Don was funny, you know?
Like, I'm not going to lie to you. I kind of respect that jab. It hurt me on
two levels.
It was well placed.
Different places. Yeah.
It was well placed.
Well, as I know, your ego won't be crushed. You still
I'm quite
somehow
resilient.
Just managed to have that confidence.
I kind of feel like you guys should start dating.
It would be a nightmare. Real nightmare.
Imagine there was an app that allowed other people to see your exes. And then, like, you know how many people, you would just devalue you completely.
Oh,
right?
My God.
I'd be in the gutter.
See you, that would be interesting. I'm going to invent that. I'm going to invent that.
You know something that sounds like a good invention?
You know what's scary, too? When your ex gets... like falls in love with someone else and then you get to like look through like who they chose and you're like, holy shit, you dumped me and now okay, like this is a lot, this is a tough pill to swallow.
Who's the monster dating right now?
Actually that's a good question.
Honestly, someone great for him. Like, she looks like she has a bush and wears Birkenstocks, and they wear tie-dyed shirts together. I think they're perfect.
But wouldn't you rather that than somebody in that, like, it's going to be, like, I don't know, Taylor Swift or something? Like, you don't want, like, them to do better than you, right?
Right.
Yeah, but no, here's the other thing, too. When you look at, like, and an ex that goes with somebody that's insanely ugly, you're like, oh my God.
It's hurtful.
Am I this ugly to society?
Right.
Like,
no, you ruined her life when you left. It's a fucking pat on your back, man.
No, I view it the other way. Like, oh my God, am I in the same value class as this
guy?
Don's
been dumped a lot.
Half class.
Klosky, you must have tortured so many exes.
That implied he had presence.
The show lawyer is busy with 30 cases. Of course I have.
All right, what's the next one we have there?
All right. Would you rather find out that your fiance had slept with one of your friends before you started dating them? Or have your fiancé call you by his ex's name at the altar?
Listen, I've been in Boston my whole life. The chances of me marrying someone from this area that hasn't slept with one of my friends is very slim. So I'm going to have no wedding party. That's what it's going to come down to.
I feel
to.
Like that's a no-brainer. Like, I think that's absolutely the right answer.
Yeah, there's even some, like, spottiness with my sisters. I'm like, did you guys make out? Because
the name thing doesn't, because the name thing's just, it could be a slip of the tongue, or that means so much because it's at the altar. that's a perfect way to get out of the marriage, right?
Oh, that's very Costanza-ish. Wait, did you guys see,
there was a thing that went viral, and it was a text from an ex the night before he gets married, and it's like, thank you so much. You truly taught me how to love. You truly taught me how to find this person and be my best version of myself. I'm like, dude, I would just be texting people like, hey, thanks for the trauma. I'll Venmo you for all the therapy, asshole.
Did you ever hear about that wedding? It was in Massachusetts at the best
man. My wedding?
Not yes.
Oh, sorry.
The best man banged the bride.
The best man.
And,
okay.
Made love.
And the yeah. And then the guy who was marrying her found, had a picture of it and taped him onto each
seat. Oh, I heard about that. Taped was that Massachusetts? Yeah. I have heard about
taped
that.
Taped him onto each seat, and they went through the whole thing, and then he was got up and at the after party. He goes, hey, everyone, look under your seat. And everyone looked under the
he
seat.
He waited until they got married?
They got married.
I heard, yeah, no, yeah. Waste the money.
Definitely.
See, this is... Yeah, he was paying for it, so he didn't
care. Right.
I just heard four I-heards, and now it makes me think that it's not true, like it's urban myth, because I just heard four I-heards. I want the story to be true, but I don't know now.
I don't know if it's true, but I heard it was.
I can't imagine that not happening with the way technology is, how people are, and that has to happen.
This, this happened like 20 years ago. I do remember hearing this. Like, I heard this story like 10, 15 years ago.
Because we've had duct tape for years now. People could tape stuff to the bottom of chairs for a while.
The technology to tape stuff has been there for at least 20 years.
I'd be out there like trying to staple it, so...
I'd be like making
Trish is chewing 400 pieces of gum.
Yeah.
What's the next one, Klusk?
Would you rather have an outdoor wedding where it downpours or get a massive cold sore in your mouth on wedding day?
Listen.
That's a great question. It's a tough one. Jesus.
A tough one?
Yeah, I mean.
You'd rather have a cold sore than have a little rain?
I didn't say, I don't know what I want to do.
Alanis Morissette wrote a whole song about this.
You would look like, yeah, like, I'm cool, look at this cold sore.
Like, we fucked last night, what?
Gross. Ew.
Your wedding pictures would be all screwed up.
I would prefer not get married.
I mean, do you want to look like you have herpes or look like a wet rat?
No, I think I would prefer, thank God, never had an STD in my life. I would
because you never slept with Dawn.
True. I've been holding off on that. That'll be a last Hail Mary.
Imagine walking up to your bride and lifting the veil and then seeing the cold sore and then being like in front of your family, your friends, everybody, and there's just a giant red goiter staring at you saying, don't do this, don't do this. What do you do?
I had a little bit of a slip up at work once where a coworker had a cold sore and I just like leaned in on it and I was like, dude, what is going on right here? And he was like, and I was like, what is it, though? It's like a mass.
Did you kiss him?
No.
You, like, try to help him, and he's like, shut up.
Dude,
don't talk about
it. Even people with cold sores are getting married. It's unreal. I can't. Can't win.
You guys want another one?
Yep.
We don't want you guys to feel left out, so we're going to do one with Don Zollo. Would you rather be a bowling champion or a curling champion?
Curling champion, not even close.
There's more gays in that field for him.
Listen, he's not gay.
They said this was a roast.
Donnie is not gay. Why are you saying that?
It's okay. I'm supportive towards Trish. I mean, she can shit on me all she wants. That just shows
he's been the most supportive guy for you.
Anyways,
when you pick
this is what I'm doing. This is what I'm doing.
I love it.
I'm going curling because I'm going to say, first off, in Canada, you're probably getting laid all the time with the curling team. Like, that's what you do. Okay? But when the Olympics come, it doesn't matter what country you're from. That carries a lot of clout. You never hear people walking out of the bowling alley talking about slaying pussy. It just doesn't happen.
You're talking about the 10-pound
pause.
You're
in Olympic Village. You just tell every girl you're like a skier or some shit. You don't tell her you're into curling.
I bet you could go to the Olympic Village as long as you were in.
Of course you can.
You could be any athlete. Because they don't know who you are.
A javeler.
Also, any mild level of success for Don is going to be a step up. So.
I think curling, that's a cool sport.
It looks fun.
It's a two-man sport. Right?
It's like watch you on ice.
Thing. Yeah.
And according to Trish, that's all I'm into is two-man sports.
Oh!
Actually, no, Don, according to all of us.
Thanks for contributing tonight.
All right.
What do we got? Is
Mr.
that
Bundy,
it?
Yep. Would you rather never be stuck in traffic again or never get sick again?
Never get sick again. I mean, traffic, who cares?
But then you get sick of traffic.
Traffic, who cares?
No, I'd rather never get sick.
I think we're being a little bit vague on sick. Like, if it's like, oh, you never have to worry about, like, cancer or something, well, then, yeah.
No, look at the picture. See, the guy's got a head cold.
All right, okay, head cold?
Don't be so dramatic.
I think you're an idiot to sit in traffic 52 weeks a year as opposed to get the flu once
man,
a week.
A man with
I don't ever want to get sick. I'm a big baby. I'm a Leo, yeah. And I'm a wuss.
Men with the flu is pretty much the equivalent of cancer.
Yeah,
so.
It's true. I don't like...
It's itchy.
I don't like being in traffic being slowed down either, though, you know? But, I mean, I'll deal with it.
I don't like being in traffic with Uber drivers. If I'm in my own vehicle,
well, that's
and
bizarre,
I have control,
but that's true. Like,
I don't like the panic of like I can't get out of this
if
car.
You're sitting,
I can't turn off.
Well,
if
you're just jump if you're, out. If you're,
I thought about it on 93. Sometimes I'm like, fuck this, get me out of here.
If you're flowing in traffic and you're with an Uber driver, doesn't matter. If you're sitting in traffic, it's like, oh Jesus Christ.
I spent Saturday in bumper to bumper traffic in the back of an Uber, throwing up into a trash bag.
What? Because the stomach
was fun. No, I ate at Chipotle. This is a... don't go to Chipotle.
Wow.
Okay, it's Chipotle, first of all. Second of
what
all...
what is it?
Chipotle.
I'm not a regular. I don't know.
No, you're putting the wrong sauces in the
that's one of our ex-boyfriends, Chipotle.
Yeah, he manages it. Probably.
I get free takeout. What are you going to do?
All right, we're going to take another quick break. Our camera guy, the ever-faithful Tonzo, who was freelancing. He did a job at UPenn... with Denzel Washington, a commencement speech. We're going to watch it right now. Check this out. We'll be right back.
Yeah! Woo! Please join me in welcoming Denzel Washington.
Thank you. I'm glad I'm back here today with you all. I'm happy. You know, my last time I was here, I left with a message and I told you all to fail big. Some of you took that message to heart, a little too much to heart, because you're not here to graduate. Yeah, well, don't fail quite that big next time. This time I want you to fail medium. Come up a little bit short of failing so big. I told you to fall forward. I meant it. Fall forward. About as far as Michael Jackson and Smooth Criminal. Fall as forward as far as the dope fiend on the corner of 95th and 7th. That's how far I want you to fall forward. Don't fall down, fall forward. You understand? Your professors, they're all here today. They're all here. You look around, you see them. Don't let them hide behind that robe because they're not perfect either. You know that? Okay? One of your professors was driving here today, cussing out everybody else on the road. Do you believe that? Some of your professors suck toes. Some of them like it in the butt, and that's fine. You know that? Some of them next to their bedside table, you open up that drawer and they have a sex toy in it. They have a rabbit, huh? They have a bunny or a rabbit, whatever they call it in that drawer. Some of your professors play with themselves. They're just like you. Be you. This year's message is to be who you are and don't hide behind that. If you like sniffing feet, sniff them. That's who you are, okay? Be you and you'll be a happier person. Thank you.
I mean, that was Corey Rodrigues is pretty good.
Yeah, he's amazing.
But the camera work was pretty good by Tonzo, too.
Yeah, Tonzo, great stuff.
Let's, I do what I can.
We should work together in the future.
Yeah. He just does nudes.
If you want to produce something funny.
He just does nudes.
No, me too. Perfect.
But that's just the beginning of Corey Rodrigues' like Breaking Balls debut. He's going to be doing more stuff with us.
Great.
Don't you have a podcast with him?
Yes, I just...
Just the two of you?
No, it's actually me, Corey, and Orlando Baxter. Obviously, Corey and Orlando have been doing comedy a little bit longer than me. So I'm new to the podcast game. I've done podcasts, but I haven't broke off and done my own yet. So I think they wanted to spice up their podcast a little bit. They're both traveling a ton. So to have two hosts
female.
At all times,
yeah, yeah.
Have a new voice. It's been really fun. They make me laugh a lot. They're really good guys, super supportive of what I'm doing, and very busy, too. They're very busy guys. So
Corey's good kid.
Yeah, both of them are great.
We should have Orlando on, too. We never had Orlando.
Get him on. You're batting 1,000. I mean, let's face it. Everyone he gets is great.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you, I snapped my fingers. And I mean, as much as I fought against having Trisha on, you guys wanted to do it tonight. And
you know what?
The majority ruled.
I bring viewers.
Yeah, majority ruled. I mean, he would.
I got to be honest with you. Both of Trisha's viewers are very enthusiastic.
Yeah. So. My dad and my mom. They watch from separate laptops.
Trisha's dad and mom, I have met them. I'm not going to bullshit 15, 20 times in my life easily. They are fucking sweethearts.
When I first started doing comedy, every comedian would tell me that I have the most supportive family in comedy. And I do.
That's awesome.
They came to my shows when I was bombing, and they still come to my shows. And
my favorite part would be to watch Trish's father as Trish would do
my jokes.
Oh my god.
My routine.
And be like, this guy's gotta watch.
Where does it come from?
Oh, because she's doing all this. Is he nervous?
No, he's actually very well adjusted. It's kind of mind blowing. But I'm like, I remember thinking like, oh my god, I can't imagine if I was watching my daughter tell these stories on stage.
But my dad gets entertainment. My dad acted a little bit in his childhood and into adult. He gets it more, I think, than my mom. My mom comes to more shows. But, my dad gets the industry more. He gets joke writing more.
You don't have any brothers?
No.
How many sisters?
One of my sisters, my oldest sister, is, the leader of the family, a typical oldest. And the other day she was like, Trish, I feel like you should try, a different type of comedy. And I was like, oh, you mean improv? And she was like, no, stand-up, but, just not what just you're not doing what you right do. Now. It's
So in other words, you suck.
Yeah, exactly. In other words, I don't enjoy anything you're producing. I was like, okay, thank you for your feedback.
I know you told me this before, but how many sisters do you have?
I have four sisters. I'm the middle of four.
Jesus.
So my parents had my sister Lara's 38, Liz is 36. I'm 34, so planned. And then they had oopsie twin girls. So, yeah.
Two bathrooms in the house you guys grew up in?
There were three, actually.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Three functioning, four in total. But that last one never
worked. That one must have smelled.
Trish took a trip in there after softball.
Who was funny
in
the family,
though?
Her dad.
Everyone. Dad's super funny. My uncle, his brother is really funny. His sister's really funny. My mom has three brothers. All of her brothers.
Do they all
funny.
Come to your shows all the time?
My uncle. I'm very excited. My godfather is coming to my headlining show, and he's never seen me perform. He was on the state police, so he's he's
straight arrow. Yeah.
I wouldn't call him a straight arrow, but he definitely has that side of it.
Cop.
No, he has both. He's a fun guy. He's like my dad. He has that side of him that's cop and then mentality, and then he also is a super funny, fun guy, big personality. Also a Leo. I'm a Leo too.
Same.
I'm sure. I'm excited for him to see me perform.
When's your birthday?
At home.
August 14th. Nice. You hear that, everyone? And I celebrate for the whole month of August. I don't want to hear anyone's shit about it.
That's cool. That's cool.
We have a show in August, actually. One of those days. We're stealing you.
Yeah.
August 24th. We got Trisha on a show at 2:22.
He's like, friendly reminder, Trish. This is the fifth time I've texted you.
I'm going on vacation. I'm going to Hawaii.
Yeah.
I just feel
I'll be in Vegas.
I feel like a cool female comedian can really go further than a guy.
Yeah.
I just really do.
Probably because
I agree.
On a
it's
horse,
it's easier for women to do stuff in general.
It's probably because of our brain and emotional capacity is so much more advanced than men. So it's just, things come much easier to us.
Especially you and Christine, you guys talk a little dirty and stuff. I think that works.
I mean, do we talk dirty or do we just say it how it is?
Say it how it is.
Yeah.
You know?
So, when I first started, I definitely was way more crass. I think I've learned how to write. So I'm better on stage and I'm better with my writing, but I never talked about topics that I thought were I'm not on stage talking about my vagina or my ass or I'm talking about real, I'm taking real situations and then I'm making them funny through writing.
It's probably because half the guys there already know about your vagina and ass.
Fortunately, a lot of those guys don't show up. If you guys could make a donation at the very least.
All right, let's go to the stupid face app thing. Now, that thing's been viral lately. And everyone's posting those pictures of what you look like in 30, 40 years.
We decided to run through our team today and see what they might look like down the road.
That's good.
First, let's take a look at the versatile Don Zollo. What will Don Zollo be doing in 2052? It looks like
looking
Mr. Bean.
Just as feminine as he
Mr. Roper.
Looks like Mr. Rogers and Mr. Roper had a kid.
Mr. Bean is what we got earlier.
That was from the audience. That came from the audience.
I still look the balls. I'm not going to lie to you.
That's a handsome older man.
You
Come
do
on.
Look like balls, definitely.
Look at Kalia Skremski and friggin' Mike Dukakis.
Dude, that is fantastic.
That's sex.
I see a little Charlie
Sheen.
For
the 12% of the audience watching that gets those references, spot on.
Guys, you know what Dom looks like? He looks like someone that pursued stand-up for a bunch of years and still does it recreationally.
You look like Ross Perot's kid.
He looks like Charlie Sheen right there.
I mean, Jesus.
First off, I'd like to thank you for putting my face in this thing that I wanted no part of seeing this ever.
I
didn't want to see it. And then, taking your face rights, and they're like, oh, anything that's on social media
your
now.
Your face rights. Yeah. What are you doing with your face rights currently?
I got my face rights, and I didn't approve of my face rights.
Yeah, what information are they going to gather on?
They're
going to
use their face. You're telling me that isn't like a sexy
fucking... They're like, wow, this guy's in some debt.
Honestly, that is a sexy nursing home advertisement waiting to happen in the 2050s.
And you look like you just got blasted in the butthole.
We typed in the magic code to be able to...
I mean, seriously, dude. Well, it's not your fault. It's a fake app.
By 2052, Don's going to be comfortable coming out. So...
No way. This kid's a stud. He's got more broads chasing him, this guy.
I also love that people always go to that picture. That's the most feminine picture I've ever taken. The left is the most feminine picture I've ever taken.
It's your eyelashes.
It's so welcoming.
And
it just says...
And the picture, 15 to 20 times a year, I'll see that fucking picture thrown up as like the advertisement if I do something.
Oh, people
and
I'm put like, your picture up
that
much,
it's the head
huh?
tilt. It looks like you're, I don't know, you like you posed for it or something. He's they like, think you want it. What's the proper, like, I'm going to make a mean face. I don't know what you're supposed to do with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, but
face.
I don't know. There's something about that face. Yeah. I'm like, get I look rid, at it and get I'm rid like, of that face. I feel like I'm getting ready for a mammogram.
You know, I'm not even going to say.
You look better now than you did in that face.
John, I'm not even going
to
say.
I just keep getting better, dude. I'm not going to lie to you.
It's not a gay face. It's a bi face.
It's not a straight face.
I'm not going to say it's gay, but I'm going to say. It looks like you're saying, hey,
it looks
don't
like,
care if you're a man, woman, trans, come fuck me.
No, it looks like, hey, I went on the... I went to vacation in Hyannis. I ended up in Provincetown, and I'm just going to roll with it.
Yeah, exactly. That's, and honestly...
I have drink tickets. I'm
have a good
to.
Time. Get
yeah,
drunk and forget
like
about it, Don.
He's having a blast.
Don, you're my guy. I love you. I support you. Whatever you got to
hey,
do.
Hey, we can all be amphibious. Let's fucking get nasty,
gender
right?
is fluid, Don. We get it.
It's just fucking...
And all my gay friends out there, I support and love you.
Same.
Two. All right.
I love how coarse your voice goes. I love you and support you.
Just want to assert my masculinity right now.
Because I'm sitting on my nuts, okay?
You guys want to do another one?
No.
Sure.
Let's Why give not? The Russians more. Next one is one of Boston's comedy spark plugs, Dave Russo.
Oh.
Dave is a seasoned comedy vet that also knows how to break dance. Will Dave still be doing head spins in 2052?
He looks more like De Niro in 2052 than he does in 2019. Jesus.
He looks like a rum dum.
Actually, he looks like De Niro now. That's what he looks like.
He looks
bit,
like someone's been
bit.
Doing opium for
little
30
bit.
Years and then he got screwed up. I mean,
I expect the
he
Russo
looks like the Andy Cap guy.
Dave Russo will never
Remember
age
Andy Caps?
Bad. He'll age gracefully. Okay.
Well, that's not
I'm gonna
gracefully.
Put Dave on a strict skin regimen tomorrow because we can't be having that face.
No, Dave's elastic. This isn't an accurate thing. I've seen that man bend like rubber. He's
yeah,
never gonna
no.
age. He's
that,
never
that
gonna
does
age.
That does him no justice.
And in 2052, he'll just be finishing the story
he's
of him covering the wrestling state championship.
Oh yeah.
No, he'll be doing the breakdance.
Yes. 100%.
Are we ready for another one?
He hit
it's
his
brutal.
Face on the ground when he was breakdancing. Look what happened to him.
I don't want
to
see mine. Where will Trisha be in 30 years?
No.
Traveling the
Hopefully
country on the Breaking Balls comedy
what
tour?
I look like.
Or settle down with her hubby on Nantucket?
Oh, Trish. Looks like you smoked.
That was like really kind of you. You think I could marry someone and live on Nantucket?
I just read the copy.
I don't
you
think
you'd
let me off
compliment.
The goddamn ferry.
Trish, you look so good on the left with your loop earring. And then
yeah.
on the right, you look like you smoked a cotton of cotton
Listen,
100.
She's also like fucking 75.
No.
She's a 75-year-old
woman.
I'm in
my 60s. That's why I think it's unfair. And frankly, I didn't do this because... I already want Botox, can't afford it. I already want to freeze my eggs, can't afford it. And now you're going to show me this?
Well,
I'm screwed.
With that attitude, I'm surprised that you're not following through on any of those.
I got to work in the water, first of all.
Do they have a reversal one where I could see what I looked like when I was a kid?
Yeah, it's called your parents.
Listen, we don't want to talk about you and kids, okay?
it's just the little basket that they left at the orphanage. That's all I got.
Thanks, guys. I'm getting married this week, and you want to show... You want to show me my future?
That
like
guy's
this.
Gonna get rid of you.
Yeah.
We got one more. This one might be the most embarrassing. Okay. The last one is Mr. Monday.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know if it's the creatine or the love of Mondays, but you don't look any older in this picture here.
Yeah.
Listen, you can thank Olive Oil. You can thank Boston Testosterone and Charlie Blaisdell, okay, for helping me out. I eat shaving cream and avocados, okay? And that's what's going to happen. And if I get an HGH, I'll look even younger. And I might get on that shit sooner or later.
Honestly, do you have a contact?
I have a contact, but I'm scared to do it. But I'll get an HGH, I'll look even younger.
Listen, after seeing that photo, I'll do it first. I'll tell you.
I've been thinking about doing it. And here's my thing. I'm like, the only part of my brain that's like, yeah, no, don't do it is like, dude, are you cheating? And then I was like, at what? What am I fucking competing in? Not feeling good? Like, why not do it?
Sly Stallone, look at that guy. Dude,
yeah.
Wait, what are we talking about?
Another HGH. Human growth hormone.
Another time that people draw comparisons to me and Sly.
You guys pumping testosterone into each other? How does that work?
Dude, I think they're like, seriously, like, people shit on it, but I'm like, why? Why? Are you against feeling good? Are you against looking the balls?
At what? So I don't get what I need to do. I'm not like moving farm equipment. What am I supposed to be doing?
You should just be feeling better. Whatever you're doing.
Well, have you tried therapy?
At his age, he did the stuff called HGH, human growth hormone.
Okay.
And me and Donnie are thinking about partnering up and getting some of that crap.
I think we should do a documentary and follow the entire thing.
Oh boy.
We should play basketball before and then 1 year after.
Actually, if we play before, you'll die, and you won't be able to do it.
Let's
wait till after.
Like. Let's put the odds up. Put the odds out there on what people think, whether Mr. Monday or Don Zollo will persevere in a game to what? What do you want to play? 15, 21?
It's 3 out of 2 out of 3.
I feel like more athletic
two
than both of you just as is right
win by
now.
2.
Without what? The human growth.
2 out of 3, win
without
by 2.
Any drugs.
Yeah, but to what score?
11. I ain't going 21.
Yeah,
how about
you
do
last.
3 human growth hormones stop working out for it, and then like some horse tranquilizers to try to balance it out and kind of just see where the game takes you?
I guarantee the game will take me to me having a fucking victory champagne bath and him fucking sulking.
You think you're going to shut me out 2 games to none?
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to. In games? Yes. I thought you meant in score. I was like, no, you'll score.
Okay. This is every date Trisha's been on in the last year and a half.
I'm like,
who's calling fouls? Like
Don's delusional self-confidence shows up again.
The referee.
Oh, we're going to have a ref.
Yeah.
I'm paying him off.
Go ahead. You can get fucking 3 or 4 fouls on your side. I'm still going to win.
You guys sound like
but
you have a lot.
If I follow you once, you might not recuperate.
Listen, I'm going to take the testosterone level down a bit and then bring it right back up with our next segment.
Klusky. Is the next segment Punch or Lunch?
It's Punch or Lunch.
I'm so excited. I love
I'm
Punch
so
or
excited.
Lunch.
Right?
It's my favorite segment.
We know that in this world, there are people that we admire and there are people that we want to hit. And we're going to do a quick round robin to see your thoughts. The first one is for Trish. She's been an actress since she was a little kid, and she's seen extreme highs and lows. Lindsay Lohan, do you want to have some drinks with her? Or punch her in her goddamn throat?
I want to have drinks with her. She's way more successful than I am. I want to hear some good shit.
She's done some crazy shit, too.
She seems
not like
I bet you
actress.
She's fun to drink with.
She seems cool.
She definitely not has cool. shortcomings, but I think she'd be fun to get a drink with.
Was she in the can?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was she really? What did she do?
She drove down a highway the wrong way.
Remember that jail mail chick from 2 weeks ago? She looks like her, but
she should have blamed her twin sister.
Yeah, right.
Then the whole thing would have been null and void.
What, she's got a twin?
No,
no, the
a movie
twin
reference.
Sister
sorry
would be the jail mail, bro.
Next one's for Don.
Thanks for paying attention, Carlos.
Don, you grew up loving this guy's comedies, but over the past couple of decades, his quantity has gone up and his quality has diminished. Do you want to grab a bite or punch Adam Sandler in his stupid Zohan
grab
face?
A fucking bite and it's not even close.
Really?
Yeah.
He's local right now.
John's like, grab him.
He's
like,
he was in
Dick.
He was in Cafe Avellino. He was in Cafe Avellino, one of our sponsors today, yesterday, the other day.
This is a
well. Maybe I'll be grabbing a bite then.
Why do you want to have a bite with Adam Sandler?
One, I love people shit on Sandler, but let me tell you, that guy has had a career.
Why do they do that?
He's done a great job.
There's some movies I don't like, but I don't care. I enjoy way more than I don't. Yeah. And it's like, the guy's been around for fucking years. Do you know how tough it is to stay prevalent that long? I haven't stayed relevant for 15... I haven't got relevant. Never mind stayed relevant.
Very true.
I think you're very funny. Well, here's the deal. I think I could sit through your comedy show longer than I could sit through the last 7 Netflix Adam Sandler movies.
You hate
in
it,
his defense...
Did you watch his last
in his
special?
Defense...
It was actually good.
Oh, no, not... Oh, actually,
the
Adam
special
Sandler
was actually
special was good.
Good.
But my point was, I grew up... I feel, like, shunned. I grew up with Adam Sandler. Those CDs, when he was dirty, and he went to the... He was doing a specific type of comedy. Then he did Little Nicky and just sold the check to the kids.
In his defense, I'm brilliant. but it, no, but like, yeah, Little Nicky, okay, it sucked, whatever, fucking move on.
Every movie after that.
Okay, but think about the classics that you can go back to and watch over and over and over and over again. You're still dying. Like, I still could throw on any Adam.
Three.
What are they?
They're a handful.
Billy Madison, Happy Gilmore, Wedding Singer.
I liked Big Daddy.
Big Daddy was fine.
They were all good.
Big Daddy was on that cusp of in between.
The last stand-up thing he did was great.
My only thing was is he got the bank at some point, and he instead of like doing what he would have wanted to do, like Grandma's Boy was a great movie, but he kind of like distanced himself from that.
Yeah, but
listen, wouldn't you do that if you worked your whole you worked your ass off your whole career and then you could just bank in on some bullshit?
This guy's I would do it. He's a real deal. This guy.
I guess so.
He plays real art on the side.
That Hanukkah song's unbelievable.
The new one, the Wallet Keys phone's pretty good too.
It's very good.
Yeah. He had a good special. He had a good special.
I think you just took our side, McCluskey.
I felt shunned. I used to wear a Yankees hat because I thought Adam Sandler was the coolest kid in the world.
You're such a piece of shit.
I'm a big piece of shit.
What's the next one, bud?
This pretty boy? Are we on the pretty boy yet? Yes, we are. The pretty boy is the pride of Portugal. On the national soccer team, over the years, he has slayed plenty of girls and gotten tons of hatred. But, Mr. Monday, do you want to go to lunch or swing a punch at Ronaldo?
I mean, I don't really have anything against the guy.
I don't either.
But I don't.
Stand closer.
But I don't really like him either. I mean, I'm all for the Americans or the Italians. You know, he plays. Yeah. But he has an Italian flag on his. He plays for an Italian team. I don't know. I don't really.
He plays for an Italian. I mean, like,
put it this way. I'd like to go out to lunch with Pele. I don't want to go out to lunch with this guy. But I don't want to. I don't hate him either. I don't want to punch him either.
Oh. Is it the beauty mark?
Way to play both sides of the fence, Carlo.
He just definitely looks like the type of guy that's getting like a soda water at lunch.
Like Michael Jordan, I want to go out to lunch with. You know, Mia Hamm, I want to go out to lunch with. Krusty Hamilton, I want to go out to lunch with. I don't want to go out to lunch with this guy. But I don't want to punch him either.
Who the fuck is Krusty Hamilton?
Actually, you know what? Look at his teeth.
The indifference.
You don't know Krusty Hamilton?
No.
Where you been the last 2 years?
Is he an electrician?
I don't understand soccer in like. Do Americans know soccer players?
We need to get that electrician back up on the show.
Do Americans know like soccer players? I don't know who this guy is.
Christian Ronaldo is the best in the world. I mean, supposedly the best in the world. Yeah, he's great. I mean, Tasso's a big soccer guy.
Yeah, I'm not shitting on it. I'm just saying. Like,
Tasso tries to do his hair like this guy.
I played soccer in college.
Did you really?
I did.
Let's have a couple stories.
There was this one.
I for 4 years.
I was good. I was a captain my junior, senior year.
Really?
How about you?
Wow, this girl is multi-talented. Tell us about your athleticism.
I was very athletic.
Really?
I played three sports.
What position did you play?
I was a center midfielder.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ran a lot.
You should tell that on stage.
Well, Don, again, these aren't relevant to you.
She could beat you in one-on-one basketball. So
yeah, thank you. I'm just more athletic than you. It's hard to talk to someone who hasn't been there.
It's amazing how many broads think that they can
out-athletic. Actually, you both played college athletics. Did you? I didn't play college athletics. You played college basketball as well, right?
Oh, I did.
Yeah, a rec league? Was it an actual team?
It was NCAA basketball is what it was.
Which college is that?
Fitchburg State.
Nice.
All right.
So where did you play soccer?
So you can both shut your dumb faces.
I played soccer at UMass Lowell.
Wow, that's serious.
Shout out Riverhawks.
Wow, that's
pretty
good. Yeah,
they're D1 now.
Yeah, they're real good now.
My sister also went to the same college as me. Wouldn't recommend.
Really?
UMass Lowell, that's my favorite porn tag, actually.
So did you score goals?
Yeah. Yeah, I was a center midfielder, so playmaker and goal scorer.
You've been a playmaker for a long time.
Yeah. I've really been making plays, personally and professionally, for a while.
So what do you got going on this weekend?
It's a big week. It's my wedding week.
You got a big show?
Yes. So I have my headlining gig Thursday and Friday of this week. And Friday sold out, so still have tickets.
They might give you Saturday, huh?
They offered Saturday, actually, Don.
I'm busting your ovaries.
And I decided, knowing my audience so well, that they would prefer the Thursday.
Trish, I love the way you guys fight.
Not to rub it in.
Don?
Huh?
Not to rub it in, but when Don headlined at Knicks, they put it on the news the day before.
Oh. Oh, yeah. No, I saw that. Someone got murdered.
Didn't he rob somewhere?
Do you remember I sent him a screenshot and I go, dude, this is a weird promo, but I dig it. Just like,
Don,
literally Don's Don's marquee in the background of someone being like, yeah, I guess you just like killed
they
her.
Kept putting, they kept putting up like man of interest captured and they'd show the marquee and it just said Don Zollo.
If you're a young 27-year-old girl, stay away from this.
Yeah, exactly.
Don, who invented the word viral?
Oh, that would be Klaus von Bülow.
Really?
Yeah.
Klaus von Bülow.
I don't know why that came to my head.
I bet you like...
I know that Klaus von Bülow is something.
Are you one of those people who like holds a tin foil to get a tan? Like, you know how those people do that?
Oh, I could see that.
I could see that. I don't know why.
I see him greased up in a driveway for some reason.
Greased up with like Crisco oil. Like, not that's even what he like, puts that shit on.
Not even at the beach. Just like...
A Speedo and a transistor fucking, radio
a
pavement, off to the side.
Pavement driveway.
Yeah, pavement driveway.
Like an old school stupid lawn chair.
Ma!
Yeah.
Breakfast sandwich. Like something like that.
Is it true, Don?
She brings
and he's
me
got
lunch.
A basketball and he's dribbling it with the fucking tinfoil.
She brings me lunch.
Ma, did you fill my car with gas?
Ma, did you see that jumper? See the way I banked it? All right, I'll stop, Don. Sorry. Right.
No, I mean... Wow.
You're going to beat me. I know. I'm fucking done. All right.
So grab tickets for your Thursday
yes,
show.
Yes, Thursday. It's this Thursday. I will be wearing white.
There's plenty of tickets left.
To the Thursday show. There's plenty of tickets.
When's the last time you popped a squat?
Wait, Don, let me just ask you. So you headlined last year?
We're talking Knicks?
Yeah.
I think I did January and March. They had me back twice already.
Oh, they did?
Yeah,
did you sell out either of those? Oh, okay, anyways.
No, it was called both of them.
So
it was called both of them.
Actually, he had there's a fucking wicked hilarious kid there, one of them. I forget what his name is, me.
Are you going to answer that question?
Last night. It was right before I came in here.
Popped a squat?
Yeah.
When did you take the last time Don popped a squat?
Right before I came in here.
Except Don probably took a BM outside. Popped a squat. He's like, no toilet paper. I'll live.
Well, listen, thank you so much for coming tonight. You did
Thanks
a great
job.
Thanks
for having me.
We want to get you up here more often.
I love Don.
Let's give it up for Trish.
She's full of shit.
Oh! Trish the dish!
Thanks.
They call him the dish!
Yeah, they do.
All right, Monday only comes once a week, so you got to live it up. Let's go. Monday on three. One, two, three.
Monday!
Woo! I'm sweating bullets over here. I'm at the Boston Man Magazine event. It's incredible. Maddie Magazine did such a great job. Look at this. There's got to be 300 people in there. But I'll just tell you what. I'm here with my guys. We're having a good time. It's a great event. John Fury's here. There's a lot of really nice people. Beautiful women. I can see women wearing their skirts. They don't have any underwear on. It's really screwed up. But everyone likes it. Even the other girls like it. So you guys doing all right?
We're doing good.
Buddy. Look at these. Your coats are almost as good as my coat.
See, we're European, right? We're from Dublin. So, you know, we like to kind of wear the fitted shit.
Are you guys soccer players or MMA fighters?
Well, we're both.
Really? Both. I want you guys in my foxhole. Okay, no question about it. I can just tell right off the bat.
We played soccer for a long time, and then we did boxing back home as well, yeah.
Right, so what are you doing here? Like, why did you come to the Boston Man Magazine?
Well, why wouldn't I be here?
Did you know Mr. Monday was going
to
be here?
I didn't, but now that he's here, I might have to join.
I'm here with Aldous. He seems to have a man crush on me. I mean, that's very common with Mr. Monday. What's going on?
Listen, Sunday used to be my favorite day. Now I'm into Monday. That's not my scene, but that's all right.
You're right.
I can just tell Mr. Monday was making stuff happen, and I wanted to see what's going on.
You seem like you might be a roughneck. Are you a roughneck?
What is a roughneck?
You know what a roughneck is? It's like someone who kind of beats people up and shit.
Yeah, right. I seem like that.
You seem like an underground fighter. Like you fight in the underground world.
Like a member of a fight club.
Just go with it.
Honestly, I'm interested in fights tonight. If anybody wants to bring it on, I'm in.
I'm with the prettiest roofer in the world. She's a roofer. Can you believe this shit?
I am.
Tell me about this.
27 years in business. I started the company myself. The name of my company is Newton Roofing Residential. We're in Watertown, Mass. I do a lot of high-end commercial, residential, and condos.
You do rubber?
I do rubber.
Rubbers.
Roofing. Yeah, I do rubber roofing.
Yeah, that's what I meant. Yeah. So let's talk about this spectacular outfit you got going on. Where did you buy it? How did you dress up like this? It's unbelievable.
Thank you.
Do you know your shoes match your hair?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Did you do that on purpose?
I did.
Now, do you think you can, like, help give me some good tips and stuff? Because I need a little stuff. I mean, I look all right, but I can look a lot better.
Nah, you got it going on, man.
Are you sure?
Positive.
How'd you get into the modeling business?
Long story, man. But I'll keep it short. So when I was younger, I was in an escalator accident. I lost my right foot. Growing up, I...
So that's prosthetic down there?
This is an actual prosthetic.
I thought that was part of your outfit.
It is now. Right. For the longest time when I was younger, I used to always try to hide it. And
be proud of it.
You have to be proud of it.
Yeah.
It's not going anywhere, so I chose to accept it. And now I basically, I designed them, and I created a new marketing strategy in which I basically design designs for companies and brands, and I model and advertise for them using my prosthetic to not only promote the values of the company, but, you know, to be an advocate for confidence, embracement, and to just, you know.
So you're like a motivational guy.
Yeah, I am.
Monday. I got John Fury here on my left, Harmon being man on my right. What about an event?
Unbelievable event.
What do you think?
We've been to several of these events. This is by far and away the best I've ever had.
What do you think, Harmon?
I ate so much, I'm gonna puke again.
Now, will you eat your puke?
Why not?
So I'm outside here at Granite Lakes. It's freaking hot as balls in there. I had to come outside, get some fresh air. And I found a man of a million voices.
The Red Sox open up another series this weekend. It's unbelievable, but right now, we're at Granite Lakes. It's unbelievable. Can you believe it?
Unequivocally, you know, we expect good things from Tommy and Coach Bill and Jonathan and winners win.
Karen,
but what happened down in Florida?
You know, I double down, cue up the tugboats.
You didn't know what was going on, did you? Hey, we're at Granite Links. It's a great night for Boston Magazine. And you, my friend, you are huge. It's unbelievable. Look at the size of him. I mean, he is like, are you a
man? You're just little.
You're just a little bit. Yeah, I have a baby fat. So let me tell you something, man. It doesn't matter how big you are. It's how good you can go. Yeah, baby.
I love my